on average, enjoy sex more, climax faster, and are more. Good morning, friends. In this video, we're going to discover, finally, whether redheads are really better in bed or not. But before we do, please subscribe to the channel if you're not already, like the video, and comment on the video to help the channel. Now let's get started. First of all, we have to define what a redhead is. A redhead is a phenotype in which people appear to have red hair. Now the redhead phenotype develops because of several genetic polymorphisms that differ across redheaded people. But one of the most important ones, or groups, sorry, one of the most important genes that affects redheads is the melanocortin 1 receptor gene, MC1R. About 50% of Caucasians, FYI, have at least one of the polymorphisms that are at that gene that are associated with being redheaded. And polymorphisms at the MC1R gene are associated with certain behavioral phenotypes, both among redheads and others. So for example, some of these people feel altered pain sensation, different kinds of painkillers work differently in them, they have like dopaminergic neurons that are vulnerable to cell death, and they're predisposed to Parkinson's disease, they're very predisposed toward melanomas and other skin cancers. We'll discuss these things in future videos. In this video, we're going to be talking about one behavioral phenotype, which is sort of a stereotype about redheads, which is that female redheads are somehow particularly crazy in bed or very into sex. This stereotype is common across Western literature. Interestingly, it is gender specific. Male redheads are not thought to be unusually sexually virile. In fact, a recent study shows that male redheads are thought to be, by both genders, male, men and women, to be less virile, less sexually potent, and also less masculine. And there may be some truth to that. Redheadedness as a phenotype is more common in women rather than men. In fact, even in twins, if one of the twins is a redhead and the other isn't, it's usually the woman. Now, what's the previous research on the subject? Well, there's only three papers I want to quickly review here. One is a 2016 paper which developed an algorithm using genetics to predict certain behavioral outcomes among people. That algorithm predicted that redheaded men and women would both have later first sexual experiences. In 2017, in accordance with a stereotype, surveyed redheads indicated that they had more partners across their lifetimes than other haired women. Though in 2019, a self-reported study again reported sort of the opposite effect in discordance with the stereotype, which is that redheaded women did not indicate that they had higher sexual desire than non-redheaded women. And finally, this takes us to 2021, where we review this fascinating Czech paper that I wanted to discuss with you guys. First of all, the paper posited that if the stereotype about redheaded women is true, it's likely true because of either hormonal, meaning biologic differences in the brains and therefore desires of these redheaded women, or it's true because redheads have worse health outcomes in life and therefore maybe lead a more risky or speedy, shorter life. Or they posited that it could happen because of social expectations. Maybe redheads, for example, they didn't say this exactly, but maybe redheads, for example, attract men who are more into them and therefore have more sex or enjoy the sex that they have even more. Anyway, what were the results of this study? The study essentially seems to have confirmed the stereotype about redheaded women. Redheaded women were found to have more sex, like sex more, have more sexual partners, be sexually submissive, and to have experienced sex at a younger age, contradicting the earlier 2016 algorithmic prediction about redheads. And in this study, redheaded men had none of these effects, at least not statistically significantly. They did appear to have enhanced sexual desire, but this wasn't statistically significant. Next, the authors did a statistical analysis of their results, trying to determine whether these individual variables, so for example, whether enhanced sexual desire observed in these redheads was a determining factor for the number of people they slept with. Because they thought if it did determine the number of people that they slept with, there could be a biological reason for redheads' behaviors. For example, that they had more estrogen exposure in their mother's wombs. But interestingly, they found these variables to be mostly quite independent, which may indicate, for example, that the redheads had more men attracted to them or more men that they were willing to date that were attracted to them, and so on. Now, I'm not sure how correct that analysis is. So, for example, I think that it may be true that redheaded women date men who are more particular about them and like them more, for example, sexually than other women. So they may have better sex lives, which may influence them throughout their lifetimes. But there's a particular phenotype among women that have higher estrogen to androgen ratios in early development. For example, women with more feminized 2D to 4D ratios. That's their index finger ratio to their ring finger. The ones that have longer index fingers per their ring finger, on average enjoy sex more, climax faster, and are more sexually submissive in bed. A lot of these features are similar to what the redheads seem to be expressing, making me think that there may be some hormonal influence. So what are the takeaways from all this? Well, first of all, redheadedness may be a somewhat feminine feature. Second of all, this year it was discovered that redheaded women, on average, behave more similarly to women that have higher estrogen to androgen ratios early in life. Specifically, that they like sex more and are more submissive in bed. And finally, on average throughout their lives, redheaded women have sex earlier, have sex more, and have sex with more people. Anyway, friends, I hope this sets your day off to a curious and light start. I wish you a great day, and I look forward to seeing you again this afternoon.